Hi, everyone. I'm Craig DeGeorge, and it is a pleasure to welcome you to another edition of Coliseum Video's official World Wrestling Federation home video series. This cassette, the triumphant story of two young men who have chased the British Bulldogs literally around the world in pursuit of that tag team title. And now, they have achieved their goal. Managed by the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, the current tag team champions are Bret the Hitman Hart and Jim the Anvil Neidhart. The Hart Foundation. The Hitman, a second-generation pro wrestler who possesses some of the finest technical ability anywhere. He is coupled with the power of Anvil Neidhart, a man who left the ranks of the NFL. He said pro football just wasn't tough enough. This tape features not only their best matches, but a never-before-seen visit to the secret offices of the Hart Foundation and the complete history of the highly controversial friendship with Danny Davis. Let's begin by taking you back to Tampa, Florida, the date February 7th, 1987. The Harts finally winning that coveted championship belt.
Davis is out on the outside with Dynamite. We're told that Dynamite earlier on took a shot from behind with a megaphone.
There's Danny Davis right there outside the ring. Oh, he's looking after the Dynamite Kid out on the floor.
Why isn't he in the ring?
Obviously, he's concerned. Now he's coming up into the ring.
He's still looking down at Dynamite. Dynamite took a shot from Jimmy Hart from behind with the megaphone, and he went down like a ton of bricks. But what's going on? There's one man in there right now. Davey Boy against two, now finally one-on-one.
Well, I don't know what you're upset about. Davey Boy's doing just fine, and it's down to one-to-one now. He's got Bret the Hitman Hart.
Wait a minute. Davis is allowing two men in the ring. Come on. What is coming down here? Drop kick by Davey Boy. Where's Dynamite?
Dynamite's out on the floor. Bret Hart. Bret Hart is out on the floor.
Dynamite, we just saw him.
Two men out on the floor, two men left in the ring, Davey Boy Smith, and he's got the Anvil up for a power slam.
And down for the canvas. Cover, where's Davis? Where is Davis?
Davis is out on the floor with Dynamite.
Where is Danny Davis? What is going on over there?
No referee to make the count. There you see Danny Davis on the floor with Dynamite.
Oh, Davey Boy's going to bring Davis in the hard way. Oh, no.
And the Hitman did the damage.
Wait, why doesn't Davis come in there and do something?
He's going back to Dynamite again.
I can't believe this.
And we're getting some vicious double teaming in the ring, and Jimmy Hart's loving it.
Davis still on the outside.
Whoa. No. Did you see Davey Boy Smith's body snap over on that double move?
Davis wanting Dynamite to get on the apron. He can't. Jimmy Hart hit him with a megaphone earlier on. What is this?
Here it is. The Hart clothesline.
No, no, no.
Three. We have new champions of the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match and new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Hart Foundation.
Jimmy Hart is ecstatic. He's taken the Harts to the championship of the world.
I can't believe that. No, he hasn't. Danny Davis has taken the Hart Foundation to the championship of the world. This is the biggest disgrace in the history of World Wrestling Federation officiating. Look at that. Davey Boy on the canvas, Dynamite on the outside. What is going on?
I'll admit it's a little controversial, but we've got new champions.
Back to the replay. Let's go back. Take a look at what happened. All right, pick it up here.
Well, here's look at this. This is after both men have teamed up on Smith. Now, look at there. Here it comes with the clotheslineer. But Davis saw the whole thing. He saw both of these two men ganked up on Smith illegally, the whole works, while he was busting on that side. And I can't believe that the title is actually changing hands.
The road to any World Wrestling Federation title is a treacherous one, and the Harts encountered some very tough opposition along the way. September 1986, New York's Madison Square Garden. That's the site for a meeting with the sensational brothers from French Canada, the Rougeaus. Now pay very close attention to the announcer's comments at the finish of this bout, because a little later in the tape, manager Jimmy Mouth of the South Hart will have some very special commentary about the finish of this contest.
See why I'm missing it by inches.
What's the matter, Chuck? What's the feel?
Well, I'm sure they think that that is a lot easier than dealing with the Hart Foundation. Forward roll into a backward roll. Nice counter to an arm wringer. Steps right over. Oh, tremendous. Backflip on the side and a drop kick. Sends a hitman down.
Oh, classical move there by young Jacques. Jacques showing the Hart Foundation the way it's all done. Oh, that was just unbelievable. What a lesson for other wrestlers watching this. Timing was perfect, balance was perfect, execution was even more than perfect.
Hart Foundation, a little bit befuddled here.
Yes, looking at each other, my goodness, what was that they said? Raymond in the ring now.
Side headlock by Brett. Raymond. On the hitman. He won't stay in this long. He doesn't like side headlocks. Shoulder block. Wow, and a beauty sends him down. Hitman down in front quickly over the top. Raymond, look out. Scooped him up, but right over the top once more. Hitman holds onto the top rope. Nice backward roll into another drop kick. And a hitman out of there once more. Holy mackerel.
The whole of this auditorium are up on their feet, just cheering these young Frenchmen. And what an impression they're making on everybody, me included.
Hitman was halfway back to the dressing room and the Hart Foundation trying to regroup here.
And they're going to have to, because these young Rougeaus boys, they mean business. And I mean business with a capital B or a W for wrestling. They're giving them a lesson personified.
Slowly crawling back in underneath the bottom rope.
Yes, a little reluctant.
Hitman, and he wants out.
Yes.
Anvil comes in. Jacques steps in.
Now then, let's see if Anvil can get this thing.
Oh, there goes the ringlet.
Up to the heart.
Former professional football star, now wrestler, Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Side headlock by Jacques. Handful of tights, gets rid of him in a hurry. Shoulder block didn't knock anybody down.
And I've got to think that Anvil is a far better wrestler than he was a football player, even though he played for the Dallas Cowboys.
Said professional football wasn't rough enough.
He likes it rough.
He wanted something without all those pads on.
Yes. Well, he thrives on punishment. He's like some other wrestlers we know. Doesn't really get going until he's been hurt, like Greg Valentine and a few like him.
Jock trying it again, and again it doesn't faze the Anvil.
Older brother coming along the ropes there to give him a little advice, something in French he was shouting to him. A little whisper between the two.
You think that the hitman gave some kind of verbal advice as Jacques was over by him? You think those were words of encouragement? Uh-oh, the Anvil now. Oh, beautiful leapfrog. Look out, scoop slam. He caught the big guy. Boston Crab, perhaps, if he can get him over. Yes. Oh, here comes hitman.
Oh. My word. That was really a super move by Jacques, but I don't think he could have held that big fellow in that Boston Crab. Do you think so?
The hitman didn't think that way.
No, he didn't.
He wasn't taking any chances.
No, he wasn't leaving anything to chance there. You're absolutely
he said, the door is open. I'm going in there.
Yes, and now that...
Here comes that double team effort. Oh, beautiful elbow.
Brilliant.
Could be all over here. One, two count. Whoa. Two and a half as the hitman questioning Dick Kroll about the count.
Yes, he was a little bit slow there, according to Bret Hart. I think he was right on the money myself. It was a two and a half count. It definitely wasn't a three.
Tables have turned here quickly in Madison Square Garden. As the hitman and the Anvil start to go to work on Jacques Rougeaus, who's out on the concrete here in the garden. Not the place to be, the Anvil right out there to meet him. Scoop slam up.
Oh, my God. This is really a bad situation for the Rougeaus brothers, because once the Harts get on top of you, they don't give you any chance at all. They keep on top of you all the time.
Raymond comes around quickly to protect his brother. Listen to that horrid megaphone.
Yes.
Come on,
And look at Bret Hart in the meantime. As I said before, they don't give you a chance.
Oh, look at that.
Ramming the back, the lower back area right into the apron.
Slammed him in hard. And Jacques is really hurt now down on the floor. His brother is there trying to console him more than help him back in. And I'm surprised because the referee is pulling a count, or at least he was, on Jacques. He is counting him. Yeah.
He's putting the count on Raymond. Why on earth would he be doing that,
Alfred? I don't understand that.
Raymond is not the legal guy inside
in the
ring.
Meantime,
that's all the referee needs to concern himself about. Look at the anvil says, look how helpful I am. I'm going to put the guy back in the ring.
Yeah.
Right into the waiting open arms of the hitman.
The foundation will continue working over Jacques now, and they won't let him escape. They're going to stay on him and stay on him and wear him down and hope to pin him.
Look at this guy running around like a crazy man. Side headlock now by the hitman. Jacques gets rid of him. Leapfrog. Right back up. First monkey flip.
Tremendous move by young Jacques Rougeau there. He monkey flipped him 10 feet in the air.
Hitman almost landing in the lap of Jimmy Hart.
Look at that, anvil on him extremely quickly, holding him in that sort of half Nelson, and just pressing him down. As I say, they're going to wear him down and wear him down. They know they can't pin him yet.
Like a 300-pound cat, the anvil.
Isn't he, though?
Front face lock, trying to control Jacques Rougeau from getting back into the corner to tag brother Raymond. Hitman comes in and distracts the referee. And also planted on one on Raymond, and here comes Raymond. Oh, look at this now.
And the hitman's ploy has worked because they've completely distracted the referee, and they've got Ramon Rougeau a little bent out of shape, too. He can't stand what's happening to his brother.
Well, I don't blame him. But it only adds insult to injury when that happens, Alfred.
Really?
Irish whip now by the anvil. Oh, duck underneath by Jacques. Oh, did you see that leg? That belonged to the hitman.
That did indeed. And I can only say right now, the Hart Foundation are showing superior teamwork. They may be bending the rules, but they're achieving their purpose, and that is to become the best tag team in the world.
Look at this now. The anvil suckering the referee back. Dick Kroll, I thought hitman would make a move over there.
I feel that Bret Hart, the hitman, thinks they've got this sewn up. And I believe they have.
Jacques in a whole lot of trouble. Irish whip in. Oh, on the second turnbuckle, nobody there. Nice Jacques. Offensive maneuver, but the anvil was ready for it.
You know something, Gorilla? I think that Jacques have bent out of shape mentally because he's trying high-risk moves, and he shouldn't be because he's not in a physical condition to do that. Mentally slow, physically slow.
He needed to go up on that second turnbuckle and run right over to his corner and tag Ray.
That's exactly what he should have done.
Because right now he's on the receiving end again. The right hand slows down the hitman. A boot in there, an elbow, trying to get himself out of trouble. He's in there, still in the wrong corner. And the hitman now with a front face lock, trying to stop him from making the tag. Here comes the anvil.
Tag made.
Tag was made. The referee did not see it. Oh. Once again, the double team effort.
Look at this move.
Oh, look at that.
280 pounds of sheer muscle and bone slamming into you, and Jacques is down. Got it covered. Here it is.
The pressure could be all over. No foot on the ropes.
Just managed to get that foot on the ropes. Otherwise, it was definitely all over there.
Mouth of the South going away a mile a minute as he smells victory for his team. Jacques in a whole lot of trouble.
Bret Hart tying him in the ropes, but
he's
hasn't
not really hooked in there.
It didn't matter. He still doesn't have the energy or the strength to move. You know, we've been in this position before, and it's not easy to get your befuddled head to a point where it says tag, tag, tag. It is difficult.
Trying to fight back, but just too strong at this point in time. The hitman, well executed. Backbreaker.
What a cruel move that was by Bret Hart.
There's that excellence of execution we talk about so much. Wasting a lot of time on the turnbuckle. Too much time as no one was there. Jacques very close to his corner now. Raymond jumping up and down on the apron. Tag made, the anvil's back in. He's not going to make it. Oh, yes, he did make it.
Oh, he's in.
Raymond in a house of fire, unloading with right hands.
Wow, look at the strength of Raymond now.
Anvil in 100 miles an hour. Oh, mule kick.
What a nice mule kick as well. Something Brett wasn't expecting. Another right-hander to the anvil.
Heel out of the corner. Drop kick by Raymond and the anvil down. Watch the hit, man. He hasn't left the ring yet, Alvin.
No, he hasn't. He's just hanging on to that rope there. But Anvil in a lot of trouble. Look at him now. Jack is fresh and very strong and very alert.
Oh, the hitman was still in there, and he got rammed by his own partner.
He got caught. And now this gives Raymond every chance to make a good winning move here if he can.
Could be all over. One, two. Wow.
Enough to get him out. Raymond should have snatched that leg and held it, because he's got a powerhouse in the ring with him, even though he's stunned and dazed.
Anvil in again, sleeper hold.
Oh, he's got it.
By Raymond, right in the center of the ring. Here comes the hitman. Oh, clobbers Ray right in the back. Jacques coming in, he can't take it anymore. And he's out after the hitman. It's a foot race around the corner here. Oh, action hot and heavy everywhere here in Madison Square Garden is pandemonium broken loose. Jacques down on the floor. In the meantime, Raymond in trouble in the ring. Oh, look at this double team effort.
That's a double team effort, but it is a team effort, and that's exactly what makes these.
Look at this shot from the outside with a high sunset flip.
He's got it.
Raymond rolls out. One, two, it's over.
Oh, whoa, God. What a fantastic move by the Rougeaus. Actually, he had him down there for a count of six or seven. I'm astounded.
Point of interest, Alfred, as the fans go bananas here in the garden. Jacques, not the legal man in the ring.
Now
let's get the official word.
He wasn't.
This contest, the Rougeau Brothers.
The Rougeaus, nonetheless, chalk up a victory here, and a most impressive one.
Wow, was that ever? I was so confused, I didn't even realize that was the wrong man pinning one of the Hart Foundation, but he did it so beautifully.
You would expect something like that to come out of the pocket of the Hart Foundation. Instead, in all the pandemonium, the Rougeaus sneak a fall on the Hart Foundation.
They are only a pound apart in weight, similar in stature, and no one can doubt that both Bret Hart and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat are right at the top of the list in wrestling and overall athletic skill. This match was the personal choice of the Hitman for perhaps his finest individual ring appearance. The result of this contest, very controversial as well. And later on, we'll have a personal analysis by Bret and Jimmy Hart, and you can bet they'll have plenty to say about this one.
Pearl Harbor job. I guess he figures he needs a little edge, Lord.
Well, I think Jimmy Hart told him. He pushed him out. He said, go get him, and that's exactly what Bret is doing.
You snake. What are you... You're going to have to pay for that, Jimmy Hart.
He don't look too bad now. He's not breathing fire now, is he, baby?
Never saw the dragon short.
Well, that was it. I said that that's what Hart did. He
look
gave him
this.
The guy.
Look at this.
Just a turnbuckle.
Into the turnbuckle. Knocked him right into the middle of next week.
Just tremendous force there, Gorilla. The way he came
in.
Chance
here for the dragon to keep things going, Lord. At least get that karate jacket off.
Uh-huh. Oh, so deliberate. The dragon is looking really deliberate. Look at the look on his face. Look at the dragon.
Karate chop right between the eyes. A hitman down. Dragon at a disadvantage. He's got to keep an eye on the mouth of the south all the time, too.
Well, the dragon's weathered that first attack, and he's come out on top. But sometimes, you know, that can pay later on in a match. And if Bret Hart can keep his attack going, if Bret Hart can keep his attack going, we may see that payoff later on.
Well, the dragon's got to be careful not to be distracted by the mouth of the south, because it doesn't take long for the hitman to do a number on you when your back is turned. Armbar now. by the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat.
A wise choice, because at that particular time, Hart was looking as if he was going to be able to weather it, but wear him down now and then attack him more strongly later on.
Well, it's a wise hold, in my opinion, Lord, because he can hold on to it and keep an eye on the mouth at the same time.
Yes, that's true. Also, a double-edged sword, in other words.
Yes. The Pasadena crowd here in the Boston Garden was stunned by that Pearl Harbor attack.
I think we all were, not only Ricky Steamboat, but I think you and I were both stunned, absolutely, Gorilla, there.
Well, the Dragon has always been very astute when it comes to being ready for a match and knowing who to watch out for. But when you've got the mouth of the South in there, the distracting, horrid thing that he is, well, you can easily become distracted.
You have to hand it to the mouth of the South, though, because before he took Bret Hart under his wing, you might say, or into his guidance, Bret Hart was just an ordinary young wrestler coming in, but look what he's done.
Oh, oh, it's a power move. Talk about doing damage to the wrist and elbow joints. That one will put you out of commission for a long time. You either go or your arm breaks, Lord.
That's absolutely true. Unfortunately for Bret, he went. Unfortunately for Bret, he was caught.
A hammerlock and a tight waist, and now he's let the tight waist go, but still got that hammerlock, and rams his shoulder right into the top turnbuckle. Well, it looks to me like the Dragon has decided he's going to go to work on that left arm and shoulder for all it's worth.
That is his game plan, I would imagine, Gorilla, and nobody comes in without a game plan. They all have something in mind.
The Hitman, most impressive. Oh, look at that nice move stuck between the legs. And one more time. And off the ropes. Swung around hard in. Oh, what an elbow.
Hart didn't know where he was going, coming. Or he couldn't see the Dragon half the time, but he sure finished up on the wrong end of that move.
The Dragon, obviously, the upper hand as far as speed is concerned in this matchup, but not a whole lot.
Good tactician, too.
Look at that horrid individual, that despicable human being.
Sometimes I wonder if it's destruction for his own man as well, Gorilla.
Sometimes it is.
I'm sure it is on occasions.
Come on up, baby, come on. Come on.
And the Hitman manages to make his to his feet now. Unloads with the right hand and made the Dragon break the hold. Bret Hart does everything with such tremendous effectiveness. He hurts you with every move he makes.
Absolutely.
Hard and nicely thrown by the Dragon. And another one. And a back throw. Oh, nice block. He tried for a hip block. And now he reaches over, hooks the leg. Now he's got it. Unfortunately, the Hitman couldn't think of the counter quick enough.
Well, he counted him twice in a row there, but Steamboat came back with something even better.
Your man is not faring
you
too
just
well.
Saw what he did.
Are you hoarse?
No, I'm not hoarse. He just pulled the guy's tights. He just pulled the Hitman's tights. He pulled him by the hair. He's used karate. He's used every legal movement.
Every legal movement. Yes,
illegal.
Every
illegal.
No, you said you're legal, Jimmy.
Upset.
Yes.
I'm going to have a nervous breakdown before
take a hike, will
here.
You please? Take a hike. Get out. Get that megamouth out of here.
I don't know how you can speak to him, Gorilla. I just can't bring myself to speak to him at all.
Well, he was so frustrated, he said that the Dragon has done every legal move to his man, and he certainly
yes, did. That's exactly what he said.
You know, sounded like he was getting hoarse. I hope he is.
I sincerely hope so. This match that started off at that fast and furious pace is still holding that pace, and unfortunately for Bret, he hasn't been able to take advantage of that initial attack that he made on Steamboat, which was so successful.
Dragon having some running commentary here with the mouth of the South could be a big mistake. Can't let that guy get to you. It'll cost you the match. In the meantime, he's put an awful lot of punishment on the left arm and shoulder to Hitman, who's trying to get out with some right hands. Not a whole lot behind. It took three of them to break the hold. Uh-oh, look out, atomic drop. Oh, nice backflip. Oh! What a reverse crescent kick right in the forehead by the Dragon. The Hitman doesn't know exactly where he is.
Oh, look at this. Oh, twisted him.
Reverse neck breaker beautifully applied by the Hitman as the Dragon made a cardinal mistake in dropping the head.
Yes, and wasn't that a good move by the Hitman, because he twisted the entire body of the Dragon. Now the Dragon's really paying for that. These two men are so well conditioned, though, they can swing the tables at any time. Just look at Hart. You wouldn't know that he'd taken all that punishment he just previously took. He's looking so commanding now.
Oh, headbutt, one of his favorite maneuvers. Dragon now feeling the wrath of the Hitman. Come on, referee. Well, that was legal. Right into the lower abdomen area.
As you said before, Gorilla, everything the Hitman does to you hurts.
Dragon in for the ride. Wow, caught one again. Oh, right outside and out of sight. Face first. Down onto the hardwood floor. Here in the Boston Garden, the Dragon is down there. How bad
on,
he's hurt, we can't tell yet.
Come on, he's hurt. You gotta get
our number seven camera on there to take a good shot. There he is. He's on his feet. Talk about resiliency. Talk about your guts. A lesser man would have been on his way to the locker room.
Quite a few minutes ago, definitely. Both these men have taken such tremendous punishment, and it's only conditioning that's keeping either of them in this match.
Hitman unloading with some big roundhouse rights. Right on the kisser, the Dragon, who's got to be reeling right now. Suplex going to bring him in the hard way.
Stood him up.
Beautifully executed. Over for the cover. We could have a three count here. Oh, 2¾.
And once again, Bret Hart gave that twist. Did you notice that, Gorilla? As he put the suplex on him, and that really hurts.
Bret Hart complaining vehemently to the referee, but the referee was right there, and it was 2¾. Chant going out from this capacity crowd, Steamboat.
I think they're intent on drowning out the mouth of the South with that dreaded megaphone there. I wanted to say something else, but I guess I shouldn't say that.
I guess you shouldn't, Ron.
No.
Dragon trying to come out with some kidney shots. And the Hitman retaliated.
Slam, scoop,
up. Quick hold up.
Quick hold up.
2½ that time.
Steamboat is just hanging in there at the moment by the skin of his teeth. And I'm afraid he is looking very much the worse for wear now.
Really dazed, looking around. Couldn't quite find his opponent there for a moment. Oh, look at this. Oh, went for a backbreaker. Nice backflip by the Dragon. And the Dragon managed to slam him, but he's really still hurt hard.
Yes, it's taken his toll, that physical punishment that he's already endured. But look at Hart. I don't think he knows where he is now. In fact, Hart's very slow to move.
Dragon. Look out. Hitman brought those knees up at the last second and did further damage to the lower abdomen of the already hurt Dragon.
I've seldom seen the Dragon make two mistakes in a row, but he's done that twice now. And he's in trouble once again.
Well, when you're dazed, Lord, you're in a knockdown, drag-out affair. You got a guy outside the ring with a horrible megaphone distracting you. Anything and everything is possible.
Absolutely.
In the
out
realm.
He goes.
Uh-oh. Out onto the floor again. Not the place to be. The Hitman going right out after him. Dragon managed to hang onto that bottom rope to keep him going.
Look out. On the concrete floor there.
Oh, slam hard onto the wooden floor. Ooh. Covering the ice here in the Boston Garden. Big congratulations there. The match is not over yet.
Steamboat down and not showing a great deal of recovery either. The signs are at the moment that he is absolutely exhausted, and he must have been hurt.
Jumped into the ring immediately to break the count before both men were counted out. And now a single count going out on a Dragon, who manages to sneak in underneath that bottom rope. And the Hitman right there waiting for him.
Power slam.
Just look at this, coming. A running power slam.
Shoulder breaker. Power slam.
Whoa! Oh!
Steamboat didn't kick out of that. He just lifted one shoulder.
Oh, the mouth of the south is hot. He's pounding on the apron.
Steamboat didn't have the energy to kick hard off.
He couldn't kick out. He had all to do to pick up that left shoulder. And the Hitman is looking very impressive.
He is, and he's looking stronger every moment, too. I'm really surprised.
Another backbreaker. Yes.
And this time, no escape by Steamboat. Last time he was able to reverse it.
That's it.
Will he go away with that blessed thing?
Reeking in pain here as the Hitman goes to the second turnbuckle on the inside. Oh, big elbow, but the Dragon was already gone. Why did that hurt?
That's the first mistake Hart has made. Could that be the little crack in his armor? Could that be the weakness that Steamboat's been looking for?
Oh, big karate shot by the Steamer, and another one. But there isn't that full impact behind those blows like there usually are.
No, he hasn't floored him with either one of those yet.
Hitman for the rest. That one nailed him pretty good.
Now he's floored
him. Dragon crawling over to make the cover. One, two, oh.
Close.
So close and yet so far.
Now Hart is dragging. Hart is dragging a little bit now. Up.
The suplex took the starch out of both men. Look at the Dragon just rolling over, barely managing to cover. Two. Whoa. And the Hitman gets that shoulder up.
I think the Hitman is playing with fire there because he's trying to get a bit more energy for a little bit more respect. But he's going to lose this match if he does that.
He's almost knocked unconscious right now. Wow, that won't help him either.
Got the leg.
Hooks the leg. Two count only.
That time Hart moved before that three count
Hitman
was coming down.
Showing me a lot of guts, Lord. The Hitman got tremendous amount of resiliency.
It's conditioning with these youngsters, Gorilla. Their conditioning is absolutely unbelievable.
Dragon upset now, shoves the referee. You can't do that. You gotta be careful.
Very careful.
Referee realizing that he's in the corner, he's trying to get him out of there. You got to give the guy a chance to get out into the ring area. Hitman going to go for the ride. No, reversal. And a double reversal. Oh, and the Dragon cuts on right into the referee. And now a nice close up for the cover. There's no one there.
Hart's going down.
Look at the mouth. Look, and he's upset.
That is a moral victory for Hart, I would say. He clotheslined him perfectly there and had him covered for about 10, 7, 8, 9, 10 possibly. In again. Another reversal.
Reversal again. Ducks underneath the chop. And another beautiful shot. Oh, and it's out of cover.
The referee, but watch this. Now, here was the crucial point. There, look at that. Right down on the back of his head, and there's no way Steamboat's going to kick out.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven. A seven count.
Dragon
still hadn't made an attempt to kick out.
And he was still unfortunate here because Hart had an excess of energy, and yet look what happened. Here he goes into the ropes. That reverse. Now, watch this.
Watch the momentum take him over here.
Boom!
Over. Nice roll up, hooks the leg, very nicely gets a three count. Wow.
When you're successful in the incredibly tough environment of the World Wrestling Federation, naturally you're going to make some enemies along the way. In the six-man tag that follows, the Hart Foundation hooks up with the rapidly improving Honky Tonk Man. And they square off with some rivals they've seen before, together on one very impressive team, the British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith, former Intercontinental Champ Tito Santana, and the Junkyard Dog.
Yeah, well, 700,000 votes were cast. However, in excess of 600,000 were in the negative vein.
He told me three negative.
complaining to Hitman about a handful of hair. Of course, we didn't see that from our vantage point. Look at that horrible individual right there. Now, he has the moniker of Colonel, did you say?
Colonel Jimmy Hart.
Any significance? They're just laid the handle on him, Colonel. What is it?
No. I mean, a lot of people think, well, you seem to think the Honky Tonk is doing a takeoff of Elvis Presley, like he's some cheap Elvis Presley impersonator.
Yeah, a poor imitation.
The man's an individualist. He just likes to look that way. That's the way he looks.
Shoulder block by Davey Boy. Hitman goes down, drop down in front quickly. Look out. Nice leapfrog. Oh. He was so wrapped up in that nice leapfrog, he forgot about everything. Here comes Honky Tonk. Here comes the anvil. He can't pick him up. Oh. Yes, he did. Davey Boy cleaning house.
Lucky. He was just lucky.
Little high five there. The JYD in the corner. And the Hart Foundation wants to regroup, Bobby.
Good strategy. That's a good move on their part. See, if the referee was doing his job. Nah, I don't want to get into that now. It's none of my business. I'm just trying to, I don't know.
Obviously, you don't.
I do.
Oh.
So, like I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted.
Sorry.
Colonel Jimmy Hart. Some people say it's the takeoff on Colonel Parker, the famous manager of Elvis Presley. No, he thinks he's earned the title, Colonel. I think he has, too.
You do. Oh, nice maneuver by Davey Boy right through the legs. Oh, look at this shoulder sit. Whole lot of things could happen here. Forward roll. Righty's got the legs trapped now. Save made. Honky Tonk Man gets a tag. And I think JYD wants a tag. Yes, indeed. Tremendous opportunity to see just how good the Honky Tonk Man is.
Well, you don't have to. You can ask me. I can tell you.
That's why I think we'd rather take a look.
Ask the Colonel.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of. Picture's worth a thousand words. Oh, big headbutt right between the eyes. He's not sure who he is right now. Tag made to the anvil, and the dog says, please, be my guest. Referee Dave Hebner warning Honky Tonk, or excuse me, JYD, about a clenched fist, perhaps. Talk about rough, tough individuals. You're looking at one here in the anvil, as he is a powerhouse. Uh-oh. Took that dog, got out of there in a hurry. There's another headbutt. He's having a good time here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Tag made to Tito.
Good wrestling, Tito. Another good hold. Punch, punch, punch.
Fight fire with fire. Front face lock now by Santana. I don't believe he'll be able to hold this big guy in one position very long.
I don't believe that team's gonna become victorious.
Well, that remains to be seen. That's what it's all about.
See, they're all individuals, Monsoon. Santana's an individual, the dog is. Davey Boy, he's not used to being there without Dynamite. The Hart Foundation.
Are you telling me that there's gonna be some continuity on the team of the Hart Foundation with their partner, Honky Tonk?
Well, they're all managed by the same man.
Well, what? That has nothing to do with
it,
really.
You think they probably train together, work out together, go over strategy together?
Probably. However, egos do strange things. Look at this. Santana unloading now on Honky Tonk. Another capacity crowd on hand for this World Wrestling Federation six-man matchup. And Honky Tonk wanted out of there in a hurry.
Good move. Smart move.
Sort of cowardish move, was it not?
What happens when the quarterback is on the field and nine guys are going after him, he runs to the sidelines? They say, what a brilliant move. They don't call him a coward.
This is not professional football. This is professional wrestling.
Exactly. That's what I'm trying to say.
Tito in there now with a hitman. Exchange right hands. Look out. Whoa. Face first right into the top turnbuckle. Team of Santana, Junkyard Dog, and Davey Boy having it all their own way here early on in this matchup. They haven't been in trouble yet.
There you go, baby. There you go, baby. Get over there. See, in tag team wrestling, you got to cut the ring in half. If you're going to be successful, they got to keep Davey Boy, Junkyard Dog, or Santana on their half of the ring.
Well, don't you think the Colonel knows that?
I would think so.
I would think so, too. However, he hasn't been successful yet.
Matter of time.
Talk about continuity. We're seeing it here on the part of Junkyard Dog, Santana, and Davey Boy as they've tagged in at least a half a dozen times now.
Were they all legal tags?
As far as I could see, they were. There's a tag to the anvil. Oh, he planted one right in the lower abdomen. Irish whip, no, reversal by the Dog. Look out, oh, ran right into that shot, right in the throat. Kind of a desperation move there.
Good strategy on his part.
What is it significant of when the anvil drops those ringlets to where they're hanging around his waist? Does that have some significance that we should know about?
You got me.
Honky Tonk Man now unloading now on the Junkyard Dog. Honky Tonk Man with something to prove here in the World Wrestling Federation. And he can prove it right here in this matchup if he wants to or if he can.
I think he's just trying to make all his fans happy.
Highly unlikely.
Every time he goes to the ring, you should hear the people yelling him. He's number one.
You must be dreaming, Bobby. Can't believe you said that.
I heard a lot of people.
Nonchalant cover by the Hitman. Not going to beat the Dog that way. Reverse chin lock now.
There's a few scattered boos, but you can't tell. It could be for Santana or the Dog.
Just like there were for when you walked out here. A few scattered boos.
I received a standing ovation.
Yes. Over 10,000 plus gave you a very warm reception. Champ going out, JYD, and it's deafening. As obviously 1987 will prove to be a better year for the World Wrestling Federation. The Dog is struggling to get over to make the tag. Referee's looking in that direction right now.
Come on, Brett, you have to keep him back in your corner.
Very, very close here. Oh, he made it. The referee saw it as Santana comes in. Maybe he didn't see it. No, he didn't.
Good tag team wrestling.
Where was the tag there? Honky Tonk Man came in illegally and told the Hitman to get out of there.
Well, they're all managed by the same man. They don't really have to tag in or out.
Please. That's not the way it works, my friend. Honky Tonk with a chin lock now. It's not a pinning combination.
I think it's fair that way. I mean, you're allowed to fight with your wife, but not a stranger. That's fine.
Made it to his feet, but not in a position to make a tag as we look right over the shoulder in the mouth of the South. Backed into the corner. In the wrong part of town for JYD. Now the anvil is going to make him carry his weight here. Front face lock.
He turns that head the right way. He can put the Dog out just like a light.
Well, you got to be careful that it doesn't turn into a chokehold.
Now, that'd be illegal.
Yes. You don't think that the anvil would do anything like that?
Sure he would. I just hope he's aware of it.
Only if given the opportunity. Fighting desperately to get back to his own side of the ring and make a tag here to the outstretched hands of either Tito Santana or Davey Boy. But didn't make it. Got to stick your hand in there, ref, and check it out. Make sure it's not a choke.
He can see. You don't have to tell him what to do.
Oh, no, you got to put your hand in there. You can't see on a front face lock. Where did the Colonel get that horrible jacket he's got on? Was that one of your rejects?
No, it wasn't one of my rejects.
Looks like something you might be caught in.
I think it's a nice-looking jacket.
Irish whip in. Watch out. Nice left-handed clothesline.
And the dog gets out on a two count. Oh, a little power demonstration here by Honky Tonk. Where's he going? Second turnbuckle on the inside, winding it up. Oh, the dog is gone. And the dog looking for the right corner. He hasn't found it. Now he found it. Santana comes in on fire, starts unloading. And Honky Tonk, the recipient, scoops him up into a nice slam. Look out! Over for the cover. No, too close, as the anvil put a stop to that in a hurry. Tag made to the Hitman. Look out, atomic drop perhaps, yes.
I think a siesta time for Mr. Santana.
Excellence of execution is what I like to call what the Hitman does. Nobody does it any better. Got caught right in the middle of that. I believe they hit head to head. Both a little worse for wear right now. Tito trying to find his way back to his corner. As Davey Boy is the French one, he made it.
Now there's a man who was running, who was retreating.
Certainly was, trying to get back to his own corner. Double noggin knocker. Come on, ref, get that other guy out of there. Oh, nice clothesline by Davey Boy Smith. Jimmy's worried. Suplex coming up. Look at the execution on that. Could be all over right here. Nope.
He didn't have him covered properly.
What's the difference?
And that's a world champion.
The anvil came in and destroyed everything anyway. All six men inside right now. Look out.
Club sandwich.
Ram together. Over for the cover. It's all over.
I don't believe Bret Hart was the legal man in the ring. Referee lost control. He should start over again.
Tremendous victory here for Tito Santana, the Junkyard Dog, and Davey Boy Smith.
This is the city, the hustle, the bustle, the action. It's a city that puts its winners on a pedestal. And what better location for the executive offices, the world headquarters of the Hart Foundation. Come with me now as we take a penetrating look inside the Hart Foundation. This has got to be it. The executive offices, world headquarters for the Hart Foundation. Wow, is this impressive. Hi again, everyone. This is Mean Gene Okerlund for Coliseum Video and continuing coverage of World Wrestling Federation Superstars. This happens to be an investigative report on the Hart Foundation. We are here at the executive offices, their world headquarters. Come on, let's take a look. Boy, is this impressive. Along the wall, virtually every award in professional wrestling. And Jimmy Hart's put it all together. He's got the tag team champions of the world. What the? Place is a little nuts, but then that figures. I'll see if I can get in to see these gentlemen. Wow. Boy, is this something. Got some bimbo here on the phone. Let's see if I can work this out. Hi. Excuse me. Hi. Sweetheart.
Hi, can I help you, sir?
Yes. I'm Gene Okerlund with the World Wrestling Federation, Mean Gene, and I'm here to see the members of the Hart Foundation.
Do you have an appointment, sir?
Are you kidding me? I wouldn't show up here without an appointment.
What is your name, sir?
Mean Gene.
Spell that, please.
Yes, I'd be more than happy. Please, give me a break. Mean Gene. M-E-A-N-G-E-N-E.
Okay. I'll have to check on that for you, sir, because I do not see you in my books anywhere. So if you'll just hold on just a moment, I'll have to check for you.
Good Lord, she's lucky she's not a blonde. Let me ask you a question. Miss, how many words a minute do you type?
Type? Sir, if you'd
forget
like
it, forget it. I had an appointment here. Where's Jimmy Hart? Get Jimmy Hart on the telephone for me.
Sir, they're very, very...
Get Jimmy Hart on the phone, would you please?
Sir, what I can do is take your name for you. If you'll just give me your name, please. You said your name was...
What do you mean? What? My name? I want to see the Hart Foundation.
Sir, if you don't mind, I can have someone show you around while I check on it for you.
Oh. Well, let's get the cook's tour.
Hi, I'm Cherry. Can I help you?
You certainly can. And yes, you are. Yeah, I'd like... Can you explain some of the great pictures here at the Hart Foundation?
Certainly.
First of all, this one over here on the left.
Uh-huh.
This looks like Jimmy Hart. This picture off to my left here. Uh-huh. Is that a picture of Jim the Anvil Neidhart's grandfather?
Yes.
With W.C. Fields?
Yeah, that it is.
Boy,
and
am I
over
impressed.
Here on the right, we have assorted awards from amateur and professional wrestling as well.
God, incredible.
It is amazing. Back there, we have steam and sauna.
You certainly do.
Over here on the left-hand side, we have our video library. That's for analysis of matches, etc.
Very small room.
Well?
Not very many books in there either.
No, no.
Of course not.
Over here on the right, we have our secretarial pool.
I'm curious, how many secretaries at the Hart Foundation?
About 200, I would say.
About 200?
Yeah.
Are they anything like, forget it. Let's continue along.
Now,
oh, that's a great shot of Jimmy Hart right there.
Yes, yes. It's one of my favorites.
What in God's name was that?
Excuse me?
Did you hear anything?
No.
Well, this place is crazy.
Anyway,
what do you have down here?
This is where we have to check your credentials, your name and so forth.
You want to check what, my press credentials?
Yes.
Well, I got permission from Gorilla Monsoon to come here. And
who?
He had made arrangements with the Hart Foundation.
Your name?
Mean Gene.
How do you spell it?
Not again. You gotta be kidding me. Here's my card. Give it back, though. I've got two telephone numbers on the back. Area code 212.
All right. We'll see.
All right. Should be interesting.
Step right in, Mr. Green Jeans.
Mean Gene.
Whatever. Ilsa will see you now.
All right. Nice touch.
Let me see your credentials.
Oh, boy. Here we go again. My credentials?
Yes.
Very good. Here's my business card. I'd like to hang on to that. I got a couple of telephone numbers on the back there.
No, this will not do. You must have the proper press credential.
How about this is my press pass right here.
Well, let me see. No, this is not the proper credentials. The proper press credentials will only get you in to see the Hart Foundation.
Wait a minute, lady. I get into any place in the world I want to go. The Pentagon. Last week I was in the White House to see the President of the United States with these same press credentials.
But
and I can't see the Hart Foundation? What do I have to do? Give me a break.
Well, you're going to have to go back to reception, and there they will instruct you further.
Oh, wait a minute. I don't have to go back to that gal back at the reception desk, do I?
Of course you do. That's where you must go to get your further instruction.
All right, I'll give it a go.
Okay.
Thank you. Ilsa?
Yes.
Very good. I'm going to try this one more time. Let's see if I can get anywhere with this young lady. Excuse me, Miss Mean Gene Okerlund, the appointment with the Hart Foundation. I want to get in to see him.
Can I help you, sir?
Hey, what are you kidding me? Quit with the nails already, lady. I've got an appointment to see the Hart Foundation.
You say you have an appointment, sir?
I have an appointment. I have an appointment right here. Are you kidding me? Right there.
I don't see you on my books anywhere.
Forget the book. Here's where the... Wait a minute. I hear noise. You're lucky you're not a blonde.
Hey,
I hear noise here.
Hey, you
get off my back, lady. I hear noise in here. Wait a second. Look at the Hart... and they're playing with toys.
I'll have to call you back in a minute. Hold on, I'll call you right back.
Growing men playing with little dolls. You've got to be kidding me. Oh, and Jimmy Hart.
You can't come. This is private property. Give me security.
Jimmy Hart,
give me security.
Jimmy Hart, please.
What are you doing in here? You can't come in here.
I deserve your time.
What do you mean? This is private property. Nobody invited you in here. How'd you get through our secretaries?
I got through. She let me in here.
What do you mean she let you in here?
Well, of course, she invited me in. She says, go right ahead.
I don't believe that. You're not even wearing pink. You broke the dress code. You cannot come in here.
I'm wearing pink. You just can't see it.
What are you doing in here? I want to know, baby.
What am I? What do you think you're playing with, sheep? I'm here for an investigative report. I want to talk. What were these men doing playing with
a strategy session? None of your business. Get the cameras off them. Don't put the cameras on them.
What do you mean?
What do you want? What do you want?
Come on, let's face the music. Talk to these cameras. Talk to our investigative report here for Coliseum Video. You've got to do it, Jimmy Hart.
For Coliseum Video?
Yes, for Coliseum Video.
Okay.
All right.
If it's for them, we'll do it.
Let's
sit down.
It.
What do you want to know, baby?
Okay. We deserve some answers. You deserve some answers. Certainly, I deserve some answers, along with Coliseum Video. Jimmy Hart, I'm very curious. How did it all begin for the Hart Foundation? How did it start?
Well, you're going to find out anyhow. It's like telephone, telegraph, and tell Gene Oakland. You're going to tell the whole world, so they might as well hear the scoop from us, right, baby? Well, first of all, when I came to the WWF, man, I saw this man right here, probably the greatest football player of all time, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the greatest wrestler of all time.
Wait a minute. Greatest football? Who did he play for?
The Oakland Raiders and Dallas Cowboys. You've seen all of his press clippings through the years. What do you mean, trying to act like
you don't know who he played for? Sure he wasn't on a taxi squad?
Oh, real cute. You know, you're pushing your luck too much, Mean Gene, but I'm going to try to finish here anyhow, okay? Don't worry, Anvil. Settle down. Let me tell you what happened. So I signed this man up. But you see, Anvil and Jimmy Hart, we had a dream. You know what the dream was? We wanted to have those world championship belts. For who came along in our life was probably the greatest scientific wrestler of all time, Bret the Hitman Hart. That's how the foundation got started. And, of course, later we added Danny Davis.
Well, Danny Davis fit right in.
Beautiful, baby.
With the scruples this man has, he fit in just very, very decently. What does all of this mean with dolls and adult men and... And what is it with these gimmicks around the neck?
These aren't gimmicks. These are neck warmers.
Neck warmers. Oh,
looks to me like a couple of mink.
And these
are mink
dolls.
If I saw one.
These are action toys. Girls play well dolls. We're men, baby.
These are action toys. But I mean, what is the significance?
Oh, strategy.
Strategy.
Good.
Strategy.
Are you hearing?
Oh.
Deaf. He's deaf.
You see the way they're all?
Five guys here.
Yeah.
Five on two.
And the snake.
I saw the snake.
Looks like a big green bean, doesn't it?
Let's talk about some of your matches, Jimmy Hart.
All right, what do you want to talk about?
The Hart Foundation and Danny Davis, the former referee, who was terminated, by the way, by the World Wrestling Federation for total incompetence.
Well, look.
Didn't make it. He got 86 by Jack Dunne.
What do you have to keep bringing that up for? You want to talk about the videos? Let's talk about them. Coliseum videos. You know, all of our matches, we get all of our videotapes from Coliseum Video. If we want them on the Bees or whoever. On that little tape you just saw a while ago, I'll tell you exactly what happened. Even Gorilla Monsoon said it. You trust Gorilla's word, right or wrong?
Of course I trust Gorilla Monsoon.
Well, good. Then you know exactly what happened. We got swerved, baby. They tried to throw us a curveball, man. The illegal man won the match. One of the Rougeau brothers, he was the illegal man in the ring.
Why not just admit?
We didn't lose that match.
Why not just admit you lost?
We didn't lose. We didn't lose, baby. That's it. Now, and on the second tape, what did you see? You saw Bret the Hitman Hart against the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat. All right. Did the Hitman, you saw it yourself. He had him pinned for a 7 count. He had the Dragon down for a 7 count. Where was the referee? He was out there picking his nose, ordering a pizza, doing something else, baby. And that's what happened to this man. He was curved once again, Daddy. We didn't lose.
Wait a minute. You've got...
We didn't lose. We didn't lose. We didn't lose. We
didn't lose. Oh, stop. Stop already. Wait a minute now. Jimmy Hart, a bunch of flimsy excuses for some very costly losses.
No excuses, it's fact, Jack. And also, in December, baby, we should have been the world champions. What happens when we face these stupid Bulldogs on November the 11th right there in Boston Gardens? Once again, Danny Davis is the greatest referee of all time. He should have been referee in that match. This other referee, he's got varicose veins. He's too old a referee. What happened? He happened to be looking the other way when we had the pin fall down. Who got it again? The Bulldogs. We should have been the world champions, and we didn't lose.
Wait a minute. Let me bring up one point. At the risk of sounding negative, Jimmy Hart, why is it that Danny Davis has $1.5 million home in Westchester County when all he did was referee for 4 or 5 years? How do you get to have a shack like that?
None of your business, because he's in the Hart Foundation, and that's exactly why.
Take a look at the knuckles on this guy. He's taking a lot of money out of the table. His knuckles are all
bruised
up.
Don't say anything, Danny. Don't say anything. You don't have to talk to this clown.
This guy some kind of a doctor?
Look, you busted in here. You broke the dress code. You bombed in our offices on our time. Took away from our strategy session. Now you want to know everything about us.
One final question. I'm very curious. You apparently have some kind of a dress code here in your offices. How many stories? 22, 25 stories. But pink seems to be the hot ticket. Is that mandatory?
Well, you see, baby, we're pretty in pink. Or I guess you can say we're brutal in pink, because you see, these guys are the only guys bad enough to walk down the streets of any city in the world, baby, and can wear pink and get by with it.
pink and mink, I guess I kind of like that. What was that?
What do you mean? What was what?
What the... Woman just came through here screaming.
Okay? What woman? You're a losing lady, man.
What do you mean? What?
You see a woman, Jimmy?
No, I didn't see anybody.
Did you see any woman?
These guys are working me. I can tell.
What are you on?
Are you kidding me?
Are you okay?
I'm fine. There was a woman that just came through here screaming.
I want
to tell you, something is going on in these offices. I hear weird noises coming out from behind closed doors. Women running down the hall screaming. There's something going on here. You got to fess up. What's happening?
There's nothing going on, man. You're hallucinating.
Now, what did he just do?
What's the matter with you?
Yeah, you're shaking all over. What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm having a little concern here. That woman screamed. Something happened to her.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What woman?
Very conspicuous by its absence here at the Hart Foundation, 25 entire floors, was the lack
of any athletic equipment, any free weights, anything in a gym setting. I don't understand. How do these men stay in shape without the weights and the iron?
Let me ask you, do you think this is a two-room duplex somewhere, baby? This right here is, we have 75 secretaries, we have trainers, we have everything here at the Hart Foundation. We have more than one room, Gene. We don't just live in this room all the time, play with these action toys, man.
Wait a minute, now what in the world is going on? You know, I see some strange things happening here, but I don't see any athletic equipment. How do these men stay in shape?
Bring the trainers.
Because we're nosy enough.
Bring the trainers. Girls, come in here. Come here, trainers. These are our trainers, baby.
These are the trainers?
Hey,
you have got to be...
Let me tell you what, these...
Wait a minute. Check this out. She's taking a mink off.
Wait, these girls are professionals. They are professionally trained to help these guys' aches and injuries out. Show him, girls. Show him.
Wait a minute. These are just a couple of bimbos.
What do you mean, bimbos?
No. Therapists. Professionals. You said...
They get paid a lot of money. They're professionals. Do I read my lips? Professionals.
Professionals. I read your lips very well. What's going on? What's happening, Apple?
Gently, my child. Gently. Beautiful. Gently.
Easy. So nice. How in the world can this ever lead to a World Tag Team Championship belt? You know, Bret the Hitman Hart, I'm going to tell you something right now. I'm going to confront you. If your father, the great Stu Hart, knew you were conducting yourself, hanging around with... He would be ashamed of you.
He knows all about this. He condones this kind of training, this therapy.
We bring Stu here once a month, baby, to help him out, don't we?
I could imagine he'd be up for it, sure. Real good. Say, listen, guys, I don't mind telling you. You just have failed, really, to answer so many of my questions. You really haven't said what I wanted to hear.
Well, you know, see no evil, hear no evil, and speak no evil. You know what I mean, Gene?
Look at a smile on that Danny Davis. You like that, don't you, Danny, huh?
Easy, easy.
Bet you could do that all night long. Sure you could, pal. Real good.
Beautiful, baby.
I'll tell you what, I give up. I give up. Let's get back to the tape, and hopefully I can probably find something out a little bit later.
Hate to see you go, Gene.
Oh, I can
Bye.
Tell that. Thank you.
I was there. World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney was there. And now, we're all going to bring you back for the truly amazing events that led to referee Danny Davis becoming a professional wrestler and the newest member of the Hart Foundation.
What is going on here? That's Jack Tunney. That's Danny Davis in front of him.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right from Knoxville, Tennessee, weighing 200...
What's going on here? Danny Davis has no right to be in there. Ooh, did you see that? Davis just shoved the referee down. Well, I'm a bit confused, is Davis? Santana, Davis is gonna square off with Santana. I can't believe it. Davis is gonna square off with Santana. What has brought all this on?
What? Referee Danny Davis is suspended for life!
Oh, my goodness! How about that? A standing ovation for that announcement! Danny Davis has been suspended for life!
All right!
For life!
All right!
How can you suspend someone for life? Wait a minute. Jimmy Hart, what is he... What is he doing in there? Do I get this right? You're telling me Jack Tunney has suspended Danny Davis for life?
That's exactly right. And what is Jimmy Hart now?
Tito Santana was so inspired by what happened with Jack Tunney, completely eliminating Danny Davis for life, suspending him for life, that he came on, and boy, did he come on of Terry Gibson. He really made sure it works on him. If we can see now, if it'll come about, we will see as
Tito
said. Excuse me?
Out of nowhere, Jimmy Hart running in there.
Yeah, but what is the reason for him being in there? I don't understand.
Jimmy Hart's the only one that can restore any sense to the whole situation. You notice when Hart appeared, everything cooled out.
I'll tell you what, Davis, I was surprised, stood right up there to Santana. He wanted to go with Santana.
Hey, Danny Davis is a man of principles. He's standing up for himself.
All right, there it was, that unprecedented move in the World Wrestling Federation. President Jack Tunney barring Danny Davis from being a referee for life. And manager Jimmy Hart, you seem a bit upset by that.
Upset? Do I look upset? I'm not upset. You see, Jack Tunney, you've made me a happy man, baby. Look at this. Danny Davis, the newest member of the Hart Foundation. You know, I've got open contracts here. Look, Danny Davis, he'll meet any single wrestler in the world right here.
Single matches, baby. Look, here's the Hart Foundation. What does it say right here? Open contracts for the Hart Foundation for the world titles. We'll face anybody, baby. And last but not least, six-man tags. Hey, I've got three of the greatest wrestlers in the world. The Hart Foundation, the Hitman, the Anvil, and Danny Davis, the newest member of the Hart Foundation. Open contracts, baby. Come on down, Daddy. Come on down. Thank you, Jack Tunney, you big fat slob. You've made me a happy man. Oh, Danny, you're great, baby.
This is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing to my right from New York City, weighing 235 pounds, Jim Powers. His partner from New Haven, Connecticut, weighing 245 pounds, Jerry Allen. Their opponents, managed by Jimmy Hart, and also assisted by Danny Davis. Here are the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions at a total combined weight of 521 pounds, the Hart Foundation.
My goodness, what a booze.
You know, you can say what you want about Danny Davis winning the title for it, but it's after the fact, and the crying isn't going to do any good. They're the champions of the world. The Bulldogs are no more. It's the Hart Foundation.
What a silly, goofy-looking outfit Danny Davis has on there, helping Jimmy Hart. And Davis is going to step into the ring as a pro wrestler. What kind of wrestler do you think Davis is going to make?
I don't know. Have to wait and see. The guy might surprise you.
We wonder whether or not Davis is going to be fearful of Santana and the Bulldogs. We asked Davis the question. Here's his response.
You know, Santana, you won't compare to me when we do battle in the ring in WrestleMania. And as far as the Bulldogs go, you're in for a big surprise, baby.
Spoken with confidence. I think Danny Davis has an ace in the hole.
Well, I think you're wrong.
I think he's sitting with a trump card of some sort. Might surprise people.
I don't think he was speaking from confidence. I think he was speaking from arrogance, and that's a big, big difference, although you wouldn't know.
Well, I'll tell you what. I mean, I would feel confident being in there. He's going to be in there with the World Tag Team Champions. That is the best tag team in the world.
But it's a six-man tag in WrestleMania, and Santana and the Bulldogs, I'm sure, are very much looking forward to locking up with the Harts and would just do anything to get their hands on Danny Davis.
Oh, I'm sure.
And they will.
Now, how do you know?
Because in a six-man...
I mean, the Anvil might give the Anvil to Chico and pin him right in the middle, and Davis might not even get in the ring.
To who?
Chico Santana.
Yes. Look at that maneuver. The Anvil, Jim Neidhart, could have had his man right there. A sensational maneuver by the Hart Foundation.
They're proving why they're the champions of the world.
Tag was made, and look at this.
Oh, yeah.
No, there was no tag made.
Bam. Oh, yes, there was.
I guess there was.
And look, they won without Danny Davis reffing. What do you got to say about that?
What I have to say about that? That's certainly not the British Bulldogs are in the ring with. That's what I have to say.
The winners of this bout.
Wait a minute, what's Davis doing?
The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
Look at Davis. Look at this.
I'm
Davis
impressed.
Davis is cleaning house.
I'm impressed. Bulldogs Chico, watch out.
And Tito unloading on everyone. Danny Davis in again. There's that patented flying forearm of Tito Santana. He's on fire. He doesn't want to. He wants to administer that punishment.
He don't want him pinned. He don't want him pinned.
It's payback time. Tito Santana going for the figure four leg lock. Wow, look at that. The Anvil, no way, shape, or form was the Anvil going to let him apply that figure four, because it would have been history right there. Tito in trouble now as he reaches Davey Boy. And Davey Boy won a lot of things to settle with Danny Davis. Irish whip in, he nailed him.
Little clothesline, is that what that was?
Yes, a clothesline was a half a clothesline, a half a punch, but he certainly nailed him with it.
Hang a bunch of wash on that.
And Davis right now in the wrong part of town. At the mercy of the British Bulldogs and Tito Santana.
Uh-oh, look out.
Pile driver. Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Pile driver indeed.
Oh,
he nailed
no.
it with it. Davis is out of it. And look at Davis shake his head saying, no, not I'm yet. Not done yet.
Not yet.
Suplex coming up. A beauty, well executed.
Danny doesn't even know what hit him.
Danny doesn't know whether he's in the Silver Dome or where he is. He's in Dream Street right now.
If he finds out, I bet he'll wish he was selling popcorn.
Uh-oh, look out. Here it comes, the patented power slam of Davy Boy Smith. Oh, look at that. Over for the cover. One,
they
two,
get out of there.
The Anvil coming in once again, making the save, and Tito with a flying elbow.
Here we go.
Oh, pandemonium broken loose, all six men inside the ring.
Here we go.
And Danny Davis over on top.
He's referee. Getting the taste of his own medicine right now, Gorilla.
Oh, look at this. A give me a break.
Oh, come on. You'll never hear the end of it.
Plenty of outside action going on in that one. Danny Davis, who was knocked right into the middle of nowhere, ends up covering for the victory. Let's go to Howard.
Oh, Franco. Man.
Look at Danny. He can't even walk.
You believe it.
And he's the victor? Give me a break.
He covered by mistake. He fell by mistake. I don't believe it. I still don't believe this one.
The winners of this contest, the Hart Foundation and Danny Davis.
Well, I have a few problems in admitting that the mouth of the South is right. However, in reviewing this footage, you too may agree that the Hart Foundation should have been champions perhaps as long ago as November 1986. So let's go back to the Boston Garden, and you be the judge.
Title on the line here in the Boston Garden. Wouldn't be the first title to change hands here, I'll tell you that.
Certainly not, when the Harts have been so impressive in recent performances. They've just absolutely torn through their opponents. Tonight, it is highly possible the Bulldogs may be on the losing end of the stick. I haven't seen the Harts look so sharp as this for such a long, long period of time. They're really, really trained to perfection. They've been waiting for this match. And they're going to take full advantage of absolutely everything.
Dynamite trapped in the corner momentarily. Now he's trying to fight his way out. Oh, yes. He does a number on both of the Harts. One Hart and one Night Hart. I like the Night Hart. There's three Harts over there.
Brad has decided, I think I'll get out for a spell and see what's going on here.
Well, the hitman got hit quite a few times over there.
Well, that really surprised me, because the Dynamite Kid doesn't usually do things like that.
Well, he knew he was in the wrong part of town.
Yes. Obviously, his partner, David Boy, has told him, hey, we've got to watch these people and treat them the way they've been treating us and everybody else.
Matilda keeping a close eye on the mouth of the South and that megaphone. I'd like to see her sneak right underneath the bottom of the ring and grab him by the leg over there.
Can you imagine? Take those pants off him again. They've been removed a few times. Davy Boy, the powerhouse of the team, is in with Bret Hart now.
Irish whip in. Oh, it got caught. Talk about speed. Atomic drop coming up. Yes, he nailed a hitman with it. These guys are so much alike in a lot of ways, Alfred.
They really are. You know, Davy Boy has got such tremendous power, he makes things look easy. Look at that, he powered out of that hole there, and it was so well executed by Bret Hart, the lesser man would have been down for three, and that would have been the finish of that.
Well, Bret Hart has to be completely disgusted and confused here. Did a tremendous move there, and had him in a pinning combination, thought he could possibly become one half of the tag team championship of the world. Next thing you knew, he was outside on the floor.
Yes. And it is that quick with Davy Boy, because he does possess that awesome power. Bret has thought, now put their awesome power in with our awesome power. See what happens.
How quickness,
yes,
can make such a difference in a team.
Yes.
when you have that quickness, things begin to work for you that ordinarily don't work for you.
Absolutely, and I think they've been training Neidhart on speed as opposed to his usual power training now. So maybe we'll look for a little speed from Neidhart as well.
Oh, he loves this kind of an attack right
yes,
here.
Doesn't
the Admiral does.
This is what he wants. He really loves it, you're right.
Oh, drove him down into the canvas. Davy Boy went to the well one too many times.
Look at that.
Could be all over right here. Two count now.
Oh, what a great move by the Hearts. They've been honing up on some different moves there, and they've nearly taken the Bulldogs by surprise twice.
Inverted atomic drop will take the starch out of anyone. It certainly has done that to Davy Boy.
These two teams are without a doubt the finest in the world.
Backbreaker off. Look at that execution. Excellence of execution. That's what the hitman has.
He really does. What a fantastic difference Jimmy Hart has made to Bret Hart alone. He's also had his influence on Neidhart as well. He's welded them into a tremendous team.
Little distraction job there by the Anvil as the hitman snuck in, dropped an elbow.
Davy Boy Smith taking a lot of punishment now. And there's not much he can do about it, quite honestly.
Oh, look at this one over here. Clothesline City.
Big elbow. They've pinned men on lesser moves than this many times. In fact, Dynamite Kid became a little anxious there and came in and made the save.
There was no tag made there.
No, there wasn't. When Dynamite Kid came in, I believe he felt that Davy Boy might not be able to kick out of that pinning combination.
A whole lot at stake here in the Boston Garden. In fact, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team title on the line. If anybody has a chance to grab it, the Hart Foundation certainly does that.
For the tandems, there is no bigger trophy than that WWF World Tag Team Championship.
Ducked underneath that clothesline.
Ducked underneath, but ran right into the knee of Bret Hart.
And Bret just turned his back to the referee.
Yes, he did, and he just halted the referee for a minute or two, a second or two, and the count only got to two. It could have been a three if the referee hadn't have turned around to remonstrate with him. My word.
Hitman slamming Davy Boy on the hardwood floor here. Nothing under there but ice. No padding whatsoever.
And Davy Boy Smith in a lot of trouble down there on that floor. Dynamite Kid exhorting him to get up. Get back if possible, because the referee is putting a count on him.
Snap mirror takes Davy Boy over. Reverse chin lock now.
The English team in a lot of trouble here, simply because Davy Boy Smith hasn't been able to make that tag to his partner. Dynamite Kid has been waiting outside the ring quite patiently. But his patience is beginning to come to an end now. He may be in that ring before you know it. Although Davy Boy in a position, if he can shift Neidhart to make that tag, that all-important tag.
Look at this move, Alfred. The referee, in his attempt to reach in and check for a chokehold, is preventing him from reaching to make the tag. Referee's lost control of this one.
Well, he seems to have lost control. In fact, now he has lost control. He's confused between who's in and who's out, and that's exactly what the Hart Foundation want. Oh, a double reverse.
Look at that. Oh. Slingshot action on the part of the Hart Foundation. Davy Boy on the receiving end, very close to the ropes, lucky for him.
Lucky for him, he was close to the ropes to get that leg over, because he was down for three. Nothing could have got his shoulders up then.
Can't believe the mouth of the South just stood by and watched him throw that leg over there without doing anything. He must have one eye on Matilda.
Yes, do you think he's actually being distracted himself?
He might be.
Oh, look at this.
Look at this. Spanish crucifix. Wow. Got him from the backside. No, couldn't hold the hitman down.
What a tremendous move there by Davey Boy Smith. I think he hurt himself as he came down, mind you, because he appeared to land on the back of his own head there.
Well, if he didn't, the hitman made sure he did.
Yes.
Dropping two legs right across his kisser.
Put the finishing touch in. Oh, look at Nighthawk saying get up. The man can't get up. Oh, gosh, a huge arm laid right across the spine of Davey Boy.
Nice block. Front face lock as he tries to make it back to the corner once more.
This is power versus power here.
Got a long way to go.
But he's making it
right over the hitman. Here comes the hitman. Look, he just grabbed a handful of tights.
Well, I knew it would happen. Pulled in the dynamite kick. And when you lose your cool like this, and lots of... Gosh, a double pile driver on Davey Boy Smith. He'll never come out from
that. We could have new champions right here. Oh.
The teamwork of the Hearts now is absolutely crushing the Bulldogs' defense of this championship. Look at that.
I tell you, if we don't get a tag here by Davey Boy, there will be new champions.
Yeah, tremendous mashup there by Bret Hart. Into the ropes.
Sleeper hold by the hitman right in the center of the ring. Davey Boy relatively close to his own corner.
Clamped on very, very tightly.
However, he's fading.
He's sinking. Davey Boy Smith is sinking under that. Bret Hart knows how to execute every move in the book.
Referee with one finger pointing towards the timekeeper. Check that out, ref. It looked like he was underneath the chin there, which makes it a choke hold.
Davey Boy holds that arm stiff. The referee knows that he's not gone yet, so he's not going to stop this hold.
Oh, look at Davey's picked him up. He's going to ram him backwards, and he does.
And there was a lot of force and power behind that, with the momentum of his own body slamming Bret Hart into the turnbuckle.
And a desperation move at that, and the mouth of the South is screaming at the hitman. He knows what's at stake here. Reversal, hitman goes in. Oh, look at this press. Oh, he crunched him.
Oh, my word. What a devastating move there by the Englishman.
It was purely accidental as he was trying to stop him. Tag made, Dynamite's in, a house of fire. Double noggin knocker, both men down. Hitman whipped in. Whoa, what a clothesline.
Great clothesline there by Dynamite Kid. Dynamite Kid, a headbutt to Neidhart. I don't know why he did that, but it was effective anyway.
Rams him into the turnbuckle. Suplex, snap one, coming up.
Snap suplex, and he'll pin him if he gets it. He's got him. No, he's waiting. He's going to put another finishing touch
to the headbutt.
The headbutt. He's still waiting. He may be making the wrong move here. He should have pinned him. I get the feeling there's... Ah!
And it's Dynamite with a sleeper of his own. Unfortunately, Dynamite very close to the wrong side of the ring. Look out. Oh, referee got clobbered.
Referee's down. Dynamite Kid is down.
Three guys.
Bret Hart is down. And now Anvil throws Davey Boy Smith out the ring. That means to say the two Harts are in the ring alone.
Look at that.
With Dynamite Kid.
The Anvil dragged the hitman over on top of Dynamite. Now he's trying to revive the referee.
But the referee's
down.
Get
up and make the count.
Look at the dog trying to. Matilda was trying to get into the ring to help as well.
Referee now crawling over towards
the
pro body.
Davey Boy. Davey Boy may be able to get in. The referee's there. One. Here he goes. Two.
Look at the anvil. He's happy.
Three. No! No! Dynamite Kid kicks out.
And the referee collapsed once more.
And a slam, a power slam by the huge anvil. And again he places Bret Hart on top of his adversary.
Referee's out of it, Alfred.
He really is. Hello, Davey Boy. Davey Boy's on the apron, coming back in.
Referee being manhandled.
This place is going absolutely berserk here.
Referee gets a one count.
He's
again.
He's got a one again. Two, he's never going to make
very,
it this time.
Very slow count. Referee not even see where he is.
He did make it. Once again, Dynamite Kid kicks out of that.
Look at the anvil, totally disgusted.
Oh, look at Anvil. He can't believe that a referee could be that bad.
Oh, look at Davey Boy. Sneaks up behind the anvil. Referee down there. He's going to cast out.
Again.
Two.
Oh. Is that going to hold up? Is he going to stand, Gorilla?
Unfortunately, Davey Boy Smith and the anvil were not the legal men inside the ring.
Matilda, she wants to come in.
British Bulldogs can consider themselves very fortunate here in the Boston Garden.
The champions, the British Bulldogs.
Well, they can consider themselves the luckiest team in the world to have retained that championship. Still the world champions, the British Bulldogs. But now look. Bret Hart has found Dynamite Kid in the ring, and he's pounding away at him.
Matilda sort of stuck over the bottom rope there, not being able to move. Pile driver.
Oh, what a pile driver to a Dynamite Kid.
Davey Boy coming to the rescue, but the damage already done. On the Dynamite Kid as the Hart Foundation tries to make its way out of here. They have to be totally disgusted.
Oh. That was just unbelievable.
Well, here's what went down in all that mayhem.
While the referee was engaged with Neidhart, in came Davey Boy Smith, who wasn't the legal man in. And at the same time, the referee was so stunned and confused, he counted Neidhart down. One, two, three. And that was the move that retained the world championship for the British Bulldog.
The Hart Foundation are the world tag team champions. There can be no argument there. And they are certainly busy keeping those belts. Now in our finale, we bring you up to date, showing the Hitman, the Anvil, and now the ever-present Danny Davis, all together in the squared circle, defending this time against the Killer Bees.
The Colonel about to decide Jimmy Hart couldn't wait to jump and take Danny Davis under his wing, could he?
He saw something there.
What kind of wrestling credentials does Danny Davis have?
I don't know.
You're supposed to know everything. You said you know everything.
But with the Colonel, I'm telling you, he saw something.
Bell's gone. This one's underway. Hart Foundation arguing over who's going to start the match. Give me a break. The Hitman finally got the shades taken off of him. And the powerhouse on the team, the Anvil, is going to start off with jumping Jim Brunzell.
Jimmy, come here. Let me conduct this interview.
Go ahead. Be my guest.
All the girls have been talking about Jimmy. He wants to know what Danny Davis is doing at ringside in your corner.
Man, this is Official Observer, man. Dangerous Danny Davis, the newest member of the Hart Foundation.
Number one, I did not ask that question. I only question what right he has to be here. My question was, what kind of wrestling credentials does Danny Davis have?
Who's doing this interview? You, Bobby, or Gorilla Monsoon?
Oh, I'll do it.
The two of you together couldn't get locked up.
He makes me so mad.
What kind of credentials does Danny Davis have?
I'll tell you exactly what kind.
Don't tell him what you told me the other day, though.
Don't you worry, I don't. But I'm going to tell you what kind of. Hey, this guy was in the Navy. He was 3 years boxing champion. He was Golden Gloves champion in high school. He won every medal to be won in high school and in wrestling. And he's with the Hart Foundation now. And I promise you this, he's going to be a dominant force in the Hart Foundation before this is over with Gorilla Monsoon.
Goodbye.
Well, Jimmy, you get back to your corner just so. Not that you're not welcome here, but I want you to keep
goodbye.
An eye on
it. Bobby, you're the greatest, baby.
You know, why don't you sit down here? Girl, why don't
goodbye. Very rude to me, Gorilla.
Get him over there. Come on, let's go, Danny.
Would you like to ask Danny Davis what he's doing out here?
Not really. High school wrestler.
Hey, Danny,
Wow, the Hitman just unloaded on Jumpin' Jim. Irish whip in. Reverse. Oh, reversed again. Nicely blocked. Flying head scissors. Couldn't get him. Slid down the back, though. Got the shoulders down there. One count only.
Referee was a little slow getting there, wasn't he?
It was a nice maneuver.
It was a nice maneuver.
Spinning armbar.
Give credit where credit is due. What are they going on? Tennies? Is that the little bees' tennies?
Certainly looks like
they've got their tennies
tennis
on.
Tennis shoes that the Killer Bees have now fashioned into some sort of wrestling attire.
That ought to be catchy, catch on quick. Lodo, you'll go out and buy a pair and walk
around with the shoes.
No, I'm saying that's nice looking. If you're going to lay in the bush all night and hunt tigers,
please. Hitman going to work now. There's a good shot of those, whatever they are.
You know what happens? I bet they just came in from playing tennis and forgot to put their shoes on. That's how bright they are.
Hitman all tied up.
Come on, Ambo, get him loose, Ambo! Get him loose!
Shoulder
Ambo! Ambo!
By B. Bryan. About to go for another one, but the Hitman's got him loose. Look out, and instead he nails the Anvil. Slingshot. Oh, right into the Anvil again.
Regroup, Jimmy. Get him on the floor.
Well, he got one on the floor. He couldn't manage to get the Hitman out of there.
Make a wish.
Oh, excuse me.
Stripes on Danny Davis. The bees have stripes. Socks, shoes, trunks.
Weasels have stripes.
Weasels have. Yes, I don't know if they do or not. I've never seen a weasel.
Okay. Here comes the Anvil.
Come on, Rick. Wake up in there, man.
I'll agree with that remark.
Hey! Come on, Hitman. Let's show them who the champions are, baby. Show them who's number one. Come on.
I'm glad that we got a chance with one of our handhelds to pick you and the Colonel, Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, on camera.
Well, thank you.
Because that undoubtedly went a long way to proving to the millions of folks that watch that you two guys are the greatest advertisement for birth control that they've ever seen.
Well,
nice arm wringer.
I resent that.
What's the corner? What's the
Speaking
corner?
Of your last comment, check
All
out
right.
Section 15 Come over there. On.
Wrapping it up with an arm ringer, Jumpin' Jim Brunzell, the man who possesses the greatest, in my book, drop kick in professional wrestling today. Would you not concur? Hello.
Hello. What?
Colleen Weasel. Come in.
You're not talking to me. Checking out Section 8 over here.
Double swing shot in here. Nice elbow. The Colonel screaming at the referee. Look out.
Uh-oh.
Come on, now you got him.
In the wrong part of town.
You got him in the corner now, baby.
Right now
no
for B. Bryan.
Beautiful, Ambo. Stay on him, Ambo.
Listen to the mouth. He doesn't need a megaphone.
No, no.
Come on. Take care of these punks. There you go, Hitman. There you go, baby.
Referee being distracted back, by the Anvil as the Hitman puts on some more
Make
punishment.
Make a wish, baby. Make a wish.
Choking him out right now.
Beautiful. 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 Come on, Hitman. There you go. Put the boot to him, baby.
You guys ever
That's
get together?
It, now you're cooking.
Bobby and compare
now you're
notes.
Cooking, Ambo.
The managers, do they ever have any meetings?
Well,
dates or
beautiful.
Anything?
No, we don't usually get together and have a meeting because you never know. One of our men might be wrestling one of theirs.
Super,
but we discuss
super,
talent.
Super,
we discuss.
Could not a lot of them have footage that you might be interested in?
Beautiful, baby.
Some of your opponents up.
Oh, yes, we discuss opponents, stuff like that, but I never discuss with Jimmy Hart, the Hart Foundation. He doesn't discuss Andre and stuff like that.
Come on, get him out, get him out.
But I'll tell you one thing. Jimmy Hart did tell me the other day that he feels sure that now he manages the world's tag team champions, and shortly I'll be managing the world's heavyweight champion.
He told you that.
He told me that.
Please. Two count.
Come on, ref, a little slow over there.
B. Bryan just kicked out of there as the Hitman almost put him away.
Come on, baby, we had the win, Daddy. Come on now, come on.
Irish whip in.
Beautiful.
Lance one right downstairs.
Beautiful.
Well, come March 29th, Silverdome, Pontiac, Michigan. The Hart Foundation and Danny Davis will indeed have their hands full. Look out. B. Bryant, lucky for him, came right down on his little sneakers, shall we say. Trying to shake out the cobwebs as around the corner came B. Bryant immediately as the anvil starts working his way around.
Bees don't have feet, do they?
These bees do. A little miscarriage of justice going on right now. Wide open. B. Bryant on the receiving end.
Beautiful, Brad. Beautiful.
Suplex
him in. The rain, Brad. Help him in. That's right.
Oh, right over the top of the back of the Hitman. Look out. Reverse sunset roll up. Shoulders are down. No, couldn't get it.
If he'd have leaned back just another couple inches, he'd have had him.
If.
You almost had him, baby.
Biggest two-letter word in the English dictionary. If. Right over the shoulder of the Colonel, so nicknamed by the Honky Tonk Man.
He's an impressive guy, isn't he?
Oh, yeah, real stand-up guy.
You got a tag, baby. Now
talk about back jumpers.
Beautiful. Beautiful, baby.
Despicable display he and the Mouth of the South put on last weekend as they clobbered Jake the Snake Roberts.
I think he had it coming.
With the guitar.
Roberts had it coming.
Roberts had it coming. We haven't heard the last of that, I guarantee.
Roberts was completely rude to the man. See, the secret to tag team wrestling is you got to cut that ring in half. You got to keep your opponents in your corner, on your side of the ring. And that's what the Hart Foundation's been doing. If these bees knew anything, when they had Bret Hart in trouble, they'd have kept him on their side of the ring.
The secret to tag team wrestling, in my book, Brain, is to have two referees on.
They do. There's one in the ring, and there's Danny Davis out here.
Well, Danny Davis can no longer be considered a referee. He is out forever.
I hear the Colonel is going to appeal that.
He can appeal all he wants. He's suspended for life
and
10 years. Ecstatic about the happenings right now in the ring here in Madison Square Garden. There's the Colonel, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. And if B. Bryant Blair doesn't get over and make some kind of a tag to his partner, the bees will be put away. The sting will be taken out of the bees. Slam.
Wow.
Tag made. Slingshot over the top rope. One.
Jumping
Jim came in, made the save.
That's all you can say. He just came in and made the save.
Well, he has a five count to get in there and get out. Was he in there for longer than five? I don't think so.
No, but it's not right.
Reversal.
Ooh.
Whoa. Hitman went in hard. Full speed ahead.
That can break your neck. That can relocate your whole spine.
Mouth of the South.
I think he's out.
Now. Obviously, both men stunned. Oh, look at that.
Well,
wait a minute, lad. Rolled him over. Two count only. Why didn't you say something about the anvil coming in?
He was out by five.
Oh.
Wasn't he?
Front face lock by the Hitman. Trying to gain control. B. Bryant fighting desperately to get to his corner. He needs to make that tag. He didn't. Wow, what shots by the anvil. Guy who said that professional football wasn't rough enough.
Not for him.
Didn't like the idea of wearing all those pads.
Helmets. Shoulder pads, hip guards and stuff. He likes this.
Whip in by the anvil. Duck underneath. Oh, got nailed from the outside by the Hitman. Right in front of the referee. Give me a break, ref.
I don't think Bret Hart hit him in the back. I think Brian Blair's knee went out on him.
He tripped, right?
I don't know if he tripped as much as his knee went out on him.
Bear hug. Nobody can put it on with any more authority
than the Bears hugs I've ever seen.
Danny Anvil. Danny Davis shouting some words of encouragement. Brian, you must make it to the corner and tag. You want to continue this match very much longer. Here comes the hitman. Referee putting him out. The tag's made. The referee didn't see it. He's going to put Jumping Jim out. No tag there. Fair.
He's just doing his job.
Oh, sure.
It's a rough job being a referee. Not only do you have to put up with criticism constantly, you can get hurt in there. Four-man tag matches are very dangerous. Six-man are very dangerous. Danny Davis, I think, did a commendable job the time he was referee.
How do you sleep at night?
On my side, usually.
Please. B. Bryan coming to his feet. Yes, I can't believe he had the power left to do that. Oh, what a drop. What a reverse drop by B. Bryan. Just about knocking out the hitman. And he's right in the corner to make the tag. He did. Jumping Jim is in and he's on fire. Irish whip in. Backdrop. The anvil gets nailed. Hitman wants out. Jumping Jim won't let him as the adrenaline is flowing hot and heavy through his body right now. Atomic drop. Yes, nailed. Oh! Got his bell rung. Irish whip in again. Oh, there's that beautiful drop kick. Over for the cover. Ah. Anvil in there to make the save. The bell rung. Did I hear the bell ring?
No, I didn't.
The bell may have inadvertently rung. Oh, look at this. Danny Davis coming in. Danny Davis nailing him from the outside. Small package. Art, give me a break.
Now, didn't Danny Davis jump up earlier to say something and he took a swipe at him?
Four against two. Miscarriage of justice once again.
Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Hart Foundation.